Hey guys, what's up? It's Alicia from Alicia Meets 6, and today I'm gonna give you guys my all-time favorite things of the month of May. Let's check out what things I like. So first thing on my list would have to be a shampoo that I recently obtained from the local Rite Aid. I really like shampoos that have argan oil in it. There are only certain brands that actually have true argan oil in it. Other ones, they might have it, but because they have it in a not dark bottle, the light that comes in, like the chemical components of argan oil, basically just decomposes with light shining through. So basically, one tip to tell if a shampoo brand has actual argan oil or that it has it in it but its chemical properties are still retained in it, is that if it comes in a very dark bottle. So I picked up one of those to try it out because I really like argan oil shampoos because they make my hair feel so nice. And this one's called Hask, and it's called argan oil from Morocco, basically like every other argan oil shampoo. And it strengthens and restores hair. So this is how it looks like. I like it so much. Like, it smells like lemons, and it's fab. It makes my hair super soft. I don't really like the conditioner with it. Like, the conditioner is good, but I feel like it just doesn't really give me the conditioning I want with it. So what I do is that I have, in addition to this, I have that mane and tail shampoo that basically every girl uses if they want to grow out their hair. And so basically what that shampoo does is that it really cleans your hair really good because it's made for like horses. But what I heard is that the shampoo really kind of like dries out your hair quite a bit if you use it every day since it's so cleansing. So what I do is that I alternate between that shampoo and this shampoo. So like I'll use this shampoo like every single day of the week and then the mane and tail conditioner with it. And then maybe like once a week, like at the end of the week or something, I'll use the mane and tail shampoo just to like clean everything out from the week and everything. But other than that, I just use it once a week. And then this, and the combination of this shampoo and the mane and tail conditioner is so great. So next I have this fragrance spray called Calgon, Take Me Away. I think that's the brand name. And it's smell, flavor, whatever, it's called Hawaiian Ginger. And this is how it looks like, and let me just tell you, it smells crazy good. Like, it's like very fruity, but like not overwhelmingly fruity. Like, you don't smell like a fruit, like you smell good. Like, you smell like a flower fruit with a hint of banana, if that makes any sense. But it's really, really good smelling, and it's not like, it's not overwhelming. I mean, unless you like covered yourself head to toe with like used the whole bottle, I guess. But it's so great, and I smell so good, and I've been getting like compliments at school about how good I smell, except for one douchebag that was like, "You smell like bananas," and I'm like, "Okay," and he's like, "I don't like bananas," and I'm just like, "Well, that's your problem. Bye." Like, who says that? If you want to smell freaking fabulous, get this shit. I got this at Rite Aid as well. So next I have this face moisturizer from the Yes to Carrots brand, and it's actually from the line Yes to Tomatoes. So this is what it looks like, and what it does is that it's supposed to clear up your skin from like blemishes and stuff, and it works. In addition to, it also helps like control any oil you have, which is great. And so yeah, there's like tomato stuff in it, and it also reduces redness in your face, and it smells like carrot cake as well, which makes me want to eat my face off. And next I have this foundation from L'Oreal, which actually came out pretty recently, and I just discovered it, and it's called Infallible Pro Matte, and honestly, it's crazy good. Like, it's supposed to help, you know, with people with oily skin, to help keep your face mattified, whatever, for 24 hours. It doesn't actually do it for 24 hours for me because I have really oily skin, so my face does get oily still in the middle of the day, but not as frequently, and all I have to do is just like repowder my face and then I'm good for the rest of the day. So it's like I only have to powder it maybe like halfway through the day and I'm okay. Versus wearing some other foundation where I have to powder it like every 30 minutes or so. This is how it looks like. It doesn't rub off on your face. Like if I went like this, like it's not gonna come off on my hands or anything. And it has instructions on the back on like how to apply it well. And it gives you really great coverage. It doesn't really give you the natural look. It gives you more of a, it doesn't give you like a cakey look either, but it gives you like a very full coverage look. And it looks great on camera, so. So another thing that's my fave is this outfit I'm wearing right now, which I'll show you in just a sec. I got it from Hollister. I don't normally shop there, but I saw it on like a similar outfit on display and I was just like, I need that. That looks fucking rad. So I got it and I love the outfit and I get like a bunch of compliments on it, which makes me happy. So I'll show you guys it right now. So last but not least, as my all-time favorite thing from this month, would have to be the brand new album, Old Bones by Broadside. And let me just tell you that the band Broadside, they are crazy good. I don't even know how to explain to you how perfect they are because they are so talented. And if you love pop punk or just alternative rock, I guess, in general, you're gonna love Broadside. Like, legit, they're gonna blow up like that. And I actually knew about them like, I don't know, like maybe 6 months or so before this album came out, and like literally no one knew of them, and they only had like a couple of singles out, and their most famous single was called, or is called, Storyteller. And I listened to it and I was just like, why don't they have more things out? Like, this is amazing. Why, what, how are they not signed to like the biggest record label ever? Because they're so great. So yeah, you should go pick up this album, Old Bones by Broadside. My top three, I would have to say, would be The Simple Type, Come and Go, and Storyteller, because those are so catchy. They're so good. But yeah, that's all my favorites I have for the month of May, and I have a bunch of new video ideas coming up soon. I've got a makeup tutorial coming up, part two actually. One of like a Lin Gun makeup tutorial, my everyday makeup tutorial, and then like a whole bunch of crazy new video ideas. Summer is like right around the corner, so there's gonna be videos from me coming left and right, so stay tuned for that. So that's all I have for today, and I'll see you guys next week.